So here we're at the same house with the panel on the inside from the service.
The meter's on the other side of this. It feeds in on these conductors. And you want to look at the size of these and pay attention to them. If they're too small and they're not rated for the same breaker, then they might need to be replaced. It may be something somebody did off permit or in the past where it's no longer to code.
And this is a modern panel. So tell us a little bit about like the modern panel and how modern panel set up versus like maybe some older panels as well.
This newer one, obviously lots of space in here, comes in on a 200 amp breaker. You can read how much service you have by the rating on this main breaker.
Right.
And if you had two panels that both had these, then it'd be a 400 amp service.
So on this service, let's say you wanted to upgrade and go higher on the amperage. Are these wires, the feed lines, are they big enough to handle higher amperage, or is this like set for 200 amp?
This is set for 200 amp.
Right.
Okay. Depending on the wires coming into the meter, we didn't open it up, but it could be that they're large enough to go up to 320 amp service, which doesn't require you to get a CT can outside. It's just a larger meter base.
What does CT stand for again?
Current transformer.
Current transformer.
And it's a way for the utility to split up a large feed on larger busing so they have room to split it up.
Gotcha. Yeah. Okay.
It's a lot of amperage.
So. And then all the individual breakers on this panel are well defined. You have a whole like map as to what all the breakers do. Wow. Sometimes some of the older panels are questionable on that.
Very often you'll find that the labeling is completely wrong or written on top of each other, non-legible.
Right.
This one's relatively new. They still kind of, you know, use pencil in case you wanted to change them, which is always
right. So convenient. You would recommend that I maybe use pen.
Yeah, something so when you, at night when you're looking and the power's out and you're trying to figure out what went wrong, you can figure out which one you want to hit.
It's a good point. Yeah,
something visible I recommend.
Yeah. But
things to watch out for even in a newer panel. These large breakers with the colored buttons on them are arc fault and GFI protection, and that's part of a new code to help protect your house and your the people in the house for safety. If you don't see those, it means you know. It could still comply to older code. You don't have to upgrade them, but it's nice to see that. It means that you have an added level of protection. The house was recently updated in the last 5 years or more.
Oh, is that about how long that code's
that
been
was,
place?
In fact, yeah, 2017 code base is when that came into effect.
Right on.
Yeah.
And the arc fault, basically, interrupter, is that what it is?
Yep.
So what that's just doing is if the feed coming in, if there's a loose wire and there's a potential arc, that interrupts it and stops it from going into the network inside the house, basically.
Well, what happens is,
it shuts
say
it off so you can't
in the house, there's a device that has a loose connection. This will sense if that connection came loose and could potentially be a fire starter.
Gotcha.
Maybe in the attic on a ceiling light you don't even know about until it does cause an issue. So this will trip immediately when it's first developing the problem rather than down the road when you smell smoke.
Great explanation. Thank you. Yeah. That's awesome. And then the GFCI or ground force interrupter.
Ground fault.
Circuit interrupter.
Right.
See how much I know about electricity.
And they're actually, these purple ones are AFCI and GFCI. So, so the GFCI part of it is to protect people.
Right.
So it stops electricity, say if you plug something in
from
that was faulty, to come through you and then to the circuit.
Right.
It actually interrupts it immediately and takes it to ground and gets rid of the objectionable voltage before it can kill you or hurt you. So, safety device for people.
So, so is that, is there anything else that you would think that would be common sense or that we should share that people would want to?
I guess as far as looking at your electrical service, if it's nice and tidy like this, generally a lot of the house will be tidy. If you see something and it's just a complete mess of wiring, a lot of times that's a red flag for what's behind the outlets.
Right.
So
I've heard of like panels having what they call floating bus bars. Is that something that you are familiar with?
So a floating bus bar is on a sub panel.
On a sub panel, correct.
So when you're looking at a sub panel, you should only see ground on a separate bar and neutral on its own. They're separate.
Okay.
That's more into the nuances of, you know, electrical wiring. So probably don't have to really worry about that. But best practices is that's separated and that's code now. So.
All right. Well, I think we got a good explanation of what to look for when you're looking at a panel, if you're looking at homes. This is pretty basic stuff. And obviously this is why we hire, you know, professionals to come out and do an inspection, because there's far more here than what, you know, you or I are actually going to be able to assess and understand. So, Cameron, thank you. Okay.